I'm really privileged to be with Dr. Sam Bunting. We know each other through work. She's looked after many of my clients and she is an absolute genius dermatologist based in London. Now, to share with my viewers what I thought would be a really good little video is to say, if I or my viewers came into you, I'm 44, please make my skin look better. I've got fine lines, pigmentation, blocked pores. Are there like three golden tips that you could share with me that would also help everyone else out there improve and make the best of their skin?
Absolutely. So, I think everyone needs good basics and then key actives. So, top of your hit list is, of course, broad spectrum sunscreen. You know, okay. We've got fine lines, we want to preserve our collagen. Anyone approaching 50 basically wants to hang on to it because we lose a third of it when we reach menopause. So, broad spectrum sunscreen, and I like zinc oxide. That gives me the most confidence when it's present at least 5% percentage.
Zinc oxide.
Zinc oxide is a physical filter, but it's really good for UVA, okay. Which is what we need all year round because those aging rays come through glass.
So look in the ingredient list, zinc oxide, yeah. Then you'll tick.
And often American formulations are better because they've been using zinc oxide as one of their key sunscreen filters for longer. So good brands to look for, Jan Marini, Neostrata, Elta MD.
Love Neostrata, I've used a few of those
awesome,
products.
Aren't they?
On that, when you've got an SPF, a high SPF 50, you have to really, really be sure that you remove that and you're double cleansing your skin because actually just doing, I've just heard, or I've just been doing a lot of research myself, that if you're using a higher SPF, which I've only pretty much been doing in the last couple of years, you really have to work hard at removing it because it does stay on your skin. Do you agree or disagree with that?
I think in general, I don't advocate using water resistant formats, which may well stay on, you know, no matter what you do. They're great for those who suffer from melasma or other significant pigmentation disorders. But for everyday, I agree, non-water resistant sunscreen. I personally believe in using a gentle cleanser and just really taking your time. Use double the amount of product you would use in the morning and make sure you do it for at least a minute, really working it in. If you need to, you can use a muslin cloth to wipe off the excess. But I just like to minimise the irritants that you get from the cleansing process. But I agree, you need to get the stuff off.
And
your
I know
skin.
From you that your approach is really, really gentle. You really sort of almost take away the abundance of products that people are using and you take them back to a very simplistic regime, which clearly works for your clients.
It's highly functional, I agree. I think you can enjoy luxury and pleasure with makeup, your domain, but I think skincare should be rational and functional.
Great. Right, so next tip.
So, you've got your sunscreen going, and I think it's a product, I would say, that is worth spending a bit more money on to find a formulation that is an effortless addition to your daily routine. So you're not looking out the window going, it's cloudy, I can get away without it. So when you're wearing sunscreen in the daytime, the next thing is your retinoid at night. So I go on about retinoids ad nauseum, but that's because they're so fundamental to skin quality and to making your skin behave more like its younger self. They regulate just about every aspect of skin function. So not only do they deal with your fine lines issue, they deal with your pigmentation issue, and they keep your pores clear. So literally, if you did nothing else but use cleanser, moisturizer, SPF, and a proper retinoid, you'd be doing a lot better than the vast majority of other women.
I've just started using one by Medicaid, and I've actually found a real difference in the smoothness and softer for my skin.
Yeah.
Do you like that brand?
Yes, Retinol Retinoid is a new kid on the block of over-the-counter retinoids, and I think there's actually really exciting data around that molecule. So, yeah, a great product and a really solid brand.
Okay, last tip.
Okay, so I would then say my next ingredient for those issues is niacinamide. There are so many reasons to combine that with the regime we just talked about. One, it makes you tolerate your retinoid better because it boosts ceramide production. Two, it's great around the eyes, which is an area where it's quite hard to tolerate the really active anti-aging ingredients, but niacinamide is really gentle. Okay. Three, it helps with pigment, with blemishes, with redness, and it stimulates collagen. I mean, literally why it's not in every single product, I do not know.
Right.
So there you go.
That is brilliant. I feel so fortunate to be able to sit here and just get all that advice from you. And I hope that everyone else out there can actually absorb and take on board what Sam has said. And we can all make ourselves look better at home with products that are available and enjoy better, plumper looking skin.
Thank you, Mrs. Bambi.
Oh, that's
done. Thank you
lighter.
For asking. No, stop it. It's not true.
Thanks.
Pleasure. Lovely to see you.